Tonight, I thought that Northwestern was such a critical game for us because of what we've done throughout the course of the season, that it was important for both sides. Northwestern was 4-0 in conference, coming in, leading the conference, something they hadn't been in that position in a long time. We're 3-1, so it's critical for both teams, but those things set up so that, you know, what you do at the beginning of the year is basically what happens. And the heightened awareness that you have towards the end of the year with these games. And I think that's what was so important for us this past Saturday night. I thought our kids played well. They were ready to play. Our defense did an unbelievable job, I thought, containing them. I think their passing attack had really been good up until this point, and I thought we did a good job of that. Same thing with stopping the run. A little over 200 yards of total offense against a team that's really been over 400 yards of total offense. So almost kept them in half of what they've been doing. And thought our guys played well. Had a couple of new faces. Ian Goodley was in the secondary. Really played well. Was second on the team in tackles this past week behind Dante and Jack Henderson, who both played well also. And then I thought our defensive line stepped up. You know, we rotate a lot of guys through there, and those guys really did a good job. We had Bryce Cage make a new, it was his first game back, got a sack and another tackle. So it's good to see him come back, getting healthy and getting back in shape. That was a nice addition. I think offensively we did some really good things throughout the course of the game. It came up short. We had to kick 3 field goals, which was really disappointing in the first half. You know, look, we opened up the game with a 13-play drive for a touchdown. And then we had some opportunities again, but we just shot ourselves in the foot. And then in the second half, it's all about the turnovers. We had 3 turnovers in the second half, and you're just not going to convert that too many times. But each time our defense stepped up and really did a good job of getting them off the field and giving us the ball back. We had a lot of production on offense. I think you saw Gage Laverdane really played well, had, you know, just did so many good things. And, he's just a dynamic player. And then Maurice Massey again stepped up, made a couple of big plays for us. So, you know, we got some guys that are stepping up and doing some things. Eli came in once Cephas went down for a little while. Cephas was able to come back. And, you know, so that 2 quarterback thing still going good for us. And then, you know, you look at Jesse Britton. I mean, what a game that guy had. You know, senior night, and his family came in from Florida. He had them all there. It was just such a nice deal. And, you know, when it goes back to when you look at the seniors and what they've accomplished here during their 4 or 5 years, and, you know, it's really kind of historic, to tell you the truth. It's had happened in a long time, and it's good to see them be able to do that. So, Nicholls week is what it is, man. You know, it's they don't like us, and we don't like them. So I guess it sets itself up, right? There's the River Bell to play for. It's everything. Throw all the records out. I know we went down the last time we played on a Thursday night in Thibodeau. We lost 44-0, and I'm not going to forget that. And, so we'll be back down there again this coming Thursday night. Looking forward to it. I know they are, too. They're excited about it. We are, too. Practice this week. It's a short week, so you got to adjust some things. Maybe, not as much hitting that you normally would be doing. But, the focus on the game plan is where the execution of the game plan is where everything's going to lie. So we'll get to where we got to go on Thursday. With practice today, tomorrow, and Wednesday, and then get ready to go for then. A lot at stake, but again, the reason there's a lot at stake, excuse me, especially for us, is because of what we've done throughout the course of the season. And that's the reason. It's this game's not any bigger than any other ones. It's just the magnitude of it is based on what's happened in the past, and that's where you put yourself in this position, which is an exciting time to be able to do this at the end of the season, which that's what I said I wanted to do. When I got here, was at the end of every year, we plan for a conference championship and a playoff berth, knowing it's got to go through Nicholls, and I think that's what's important for us. So, with that, I'll take any questions from everybody.
Coach, going off that, isn't it kind of a plus for you guys to have a rivalry game that defines so much, so that your guys focus more versus playing, an inferior opponent?
You know, I guess, Matt, you know, when you – I guess it depends on where you are in your season and how you're doing, right? We got a chance to win the conference championship, go to the playoffs. Nicholls doesn't have that. Does that mean the game's less for them? I don't think so. I think they'll be just as excited if they were in this switch positions. I think it'll be the same. So, it could possibly be that. But at the same time, the opportunity to play this game is just one last chance. It's senior night for them, right? So they got some guys that have really been productive in their program that they're going to try to get out on the right foot. And, you know, so it's a huge game for them also.
How much of an eye-opener was last year's game, knowing just like this year you have so much to lose? How much more prepared and conscious of, I guess, the whole situation surrounding this game will your guys be?
Yeah, I don't look at it as we got stuff to lose. We got stuff to gain, right? You can look at it whichever way you want. We got stuff to gain. And we had a chance to win the conference last year, and we didn't get it done here on our home field. Same thing in 19. We had a chance to win the conference here, didn't get it done on our home field. So when we got an opportunity, we got to take advantage of it because they don't come around too often. And now we got a chance to do it again. We got to take care of our business. But then, you know, just roll your hat out there and win. You know, there's so much that you can accomplish by doing it the right way and getting it done, and that's what we're looking to do on this.
Coach Rebo said he enjoyed, really, you know, how the past few meetings between you guys have been so close, tight contest.
Yeah.
When the games are like that, what makes this rivalry so much better?
Well, because the games are like that. You know, when you beat somebody every time and you win, you can say it's a rivalry, but it's not. You know, you just know you're going to win. Well, with these guys, I mean, you take out the 18 game, every game's been decided, you know, right there towards the end of the game. And they've all been nail biters, and they've all been, they had so much in at stake, you know, throughout these last four games that we played. They've won both times here in Hammond. We've won both times there in Thibodeau. So, you know, that tells you the fan bases don't like each other, I don't think. You know, there's a lot of stuff being said during the course of the game from the stands and on both sides, which is awesome. It's college football, right? And that's what you want to see.
And the last four games have been won by the road teams. Coach, why do you think, just from your perspective, that is the road team has so much advantage?
They score more points, I guess. I don't know. I got no idea. That I couldn't even tell you. You know, I know both teams prepare well and play well. They're both well coached. They're both ready to play. It comes out like it does, you know, at the end of the deal. But it's come down to the end of the game in all of these games.
Coach, when you look at the beginning of this season and versus now, going into last week, the regular season, what kind of team do you have now versus the one that started? And I guess what's the biggest area of growth? What are you the most excited about that you've seen the most progression?
Yeah, you know, the injury situation this year has been unbelievable for us, Matt. We've had to overcome so many injuries to higher level guys, juniors and seniors, starters, 2-3 year returning guys, and we lost them for the season. To me, the best part has been our young guys, our freshmen and sophomore, being thrown in the fire, and they've made a lot of mistakes, but boy, they played hard. They've given everything we've asked. They've developed. They've grown. Our coaching staff has just done an unbelievable job growing these guys up and putting it in this position. We lose our first two games, and now we've won 7 out of the last 8, and it's because of the growth of our young kids. And it's, you know, you watch them each and every week, and again, they make mistakes. But boy, the effort that they're giving you, the what they're doing, stepping up, and it's awesome to watch as a coach, watching those guys practice and develop each and every day the way they approach it.
I look at a lot of these games, and the one that sticks out is the McNeese game where it was close. And why are you guys so comfortable getting uncomfortable now? I mean, has that been something that's been developed? Has that just been this identity of this team this year?
Well, because we got a lot of new faces, right? So because you got a lot of new faces, you got guys that are going to make mistakes at critical times because they never experienced those situations. And we talk about it all the time. The only way that you can grow is to be uncomfortable. When you get too comfortable, you quit growing. It's stagnant. So we create, sometimes at practice, we create situations where we change up routines. So it forces them to be uncomfortable, so they have to deal with some adversity. But I think, and it goes back to your previous question, we've had to overcome so much adversity during the course of this season, whether it be injuries or turnovers or big plays. We've had to overcome those things, and our guys have not blinked. They just continue to do that. And that's the, I guess, the refreshing part for me. Nobody goes to the sidelines complaining, pointing fingers or anything like that. That's not happening. And usually it happens with an immature group, but these guys have come together. I said at the beginning of the year, I thought the culture in the locker room and the overall in the program is really good. And that's what's taken over and putting us in this situation for that.
How important was it last week to be able to run the ball so effectively? Really all year, when y'all haven't, that hadn't been y'all's top you know, top statistical thing is running the football when it was windy and it was cold, and y'all were able to just put the ball on the ground and get it done.
Yeah, we, you know, the wind was a factor last week, but we had more yardage thrown into the wind than we did throwing with the wind. But running the football is always going to be important when we want to be able to run it. I think we've got, we said at the beginning of the year, identity's kind of moving a little bit as far as run first, throw first. We really don't care, but we're able to run the football when we want to run it. And I think our backs have done a good job doing what they need to be doing. But our offensive line, it's been piecemeal together, and we've had guys step up and do such a great job. We've lost a lot of linemen during the course of the season. And those other guys have come in and done a heck of a job being able to pave the way for us to be able to run the ball.
What's the toughest part about having four capable backs? Is it just getting them all reps? Is it keeping all of them happy at the same time? Because it seems like it's been seamless today.
Yeah, nobody's happy, Matt, unless they get the ball, right? There's not a back or receiver that's happy unless they're getting the ball. But I think what's really good is that both of those rooms, the receiver room and the running back room, the guys that are coaching those guys in there really have created a camaraderie that they pull for each other. So even though it might not be me, at least it's my really good friend, my buddy, who's doing that. There's not a lot of people that are jealous of the other one. And I think that's where you're seeing that. You see that all of those guys play special teams, which is pretty cool. No, I'm the starting running back. I'm not playing special teams. I'm a starting receiver. I'm not playing special. All these guys play everything, you know, and it allows us to get our best players on the field. So I think it's the culture within that meeting room position group that allows them to pull for each other when the other one's out there.
This is the third straight week y'all are going to play a team coming off of a big win when they haven't had many throughout the year, and they had a bye before the win. When you watch the video of all these three, are they throwing something in that bye week that maybe is new that they haven't been doing?
Yeah, well, it's the third straight week that people got to play us coming off a big win too. So that's four straight week, right? So I'm good with that too. They better be getting ready for us, putting in some new stuff. Sometimes they do, sometimes they don't. You see guys get healthy, so you might see an extra guy or two in there, but they just happen to win. Now it's their turn to play against us.
Coach, last year, I know Colin Guggenheim had a big game here.
Yeah.
This year, you know, they have him and they get Julian Gums back.
Yeah.
How difficult is it to prepare for really that 1-2 punch?
Yeah, Colin had a career day here, man. I mean, he opened it up, and their offensive line did a great job against us last year. We didn't adjust well to it. We know we're going to have to stop the run. Julian's really playing well this year. He's having a big season. It's his last year. He's probably got every rushing record that Nicholls has, or most of them. He's in the top five in every category. He's been such a good player since I've been here. And so we know that we're going to have to stop those guys or slow them down. I don't think you can stop them, but I think you can slow them down, put them in some long yardage situations where they're not going to be the guy that's going to be getting the ball. It's going to be a chore for our defense, especially on a short week, to be able to scheme up some things. We're going to just have to play well.
Can you just elaborate on the season Jack Anderson has had in that secondary? I feel like he's a guy that's a silent assassin, doesn't talk a whole lot, but does so much, and we probably haven't given him the love that he needs.
Well, he does talk a lot, so he's not silent, and he is an assassin. I'll put it to you like that. He's, Matt, he is – I think he's one of the best defensive players we have played against that I've seen. I think he's an All-American candidate. I think he's one of those guys who's just around the football all the time. He's either first or second in tackles for us just about every week. He's a turnover machine. He's forcing turnovers. He forces plays. He's a physical player. He plays with so much energy. He's one of those guys that doesn't come around too often, you know, and we're so happy he ended up here. We had him in camp as a senior, after going into his senior season, and just fell in love with him and recruited the heck out of him and got him here. And he has just been so consistent for us as a player. He's, like I said, he's around the ball all the time. He's made big plays since he's been here, and he's done it again this year. And everybody knows about him. Maybe y'all didn't give him the pub, but I know our team does. Everybody has a great deal of respect, and so do the opposing teams. They know where he's at all times too.
How much do you talk about your team, about the history of the rivalry going into the week a little bit?
Not much, to tell you the truth. They played against Nicholls. They don't like them, and Nicholls doesn't like us, and they know that's the case, and that's just the way it is. And